sex. But sometimes it becomes too emotional, too controversial, and we wonder where those facts are. And then why is he becoming so emotional about it? He's trying to persuade you to buy something from you or to do something for you. Then that is something to be very, very careful. This is not academic. It becomes an or non-academic nature. So it's not objective. And kadang-kadang setengah artikel itu more like propaganda, kan? More like, okay, you already say yes. They claim to do this and that for you, but we know they are more propaganda than anything else. And good, and they have their personal agenda they want to invest in. They want to further their personal agenda. Like for example, macam kita write something, and we are so attracted to what this person says about certain topic dalam blog dia. Be careful, kita ambil item dari blog tu kena jaga-jaga. If kata betul nanti, you'll be in trouble. You'll be questioned maybe, you know. Why do you choose this info or this item or these statements that you've extracted from this particular writer? And the writer you want to also quote must also be the ones that will not get you into trouble. Okay, so be objective about all things. It's based on facts, go and take it. But if you feel or you have already done your evaluation and you found out that no, these are some of the things that he has addressed which are not purely factual and not substantiated. Dia tak ada sokongan hujah. Okay, jadi kita tak boleh terima lah. Okay? Because don't forget, when you write your work, your essay, yours is very much academic. Academic essay. Penulisan ilmiah. So, mesti bersandarkan fakta dan even hujah-hujah dari mereka yang menggunakan fakta juga. Dan it becomes strong, academic, well-substantiated arguments. And of course, you can give your opinion, okay? But just not anyone's feeling, not based on feelings. Okay, dah ada objectivity, reliability, authority, and there's one more left. Scope. There's one left. Scope. Yang kelima kan? Yang kelima ialah keempat kelima. Kelima keempat. Ketiga ni keempat sekarang. Sekarang keempat, currency. Lepas currency scope. Apa tu currency? Bukan mata wang . Currency bukan mata wang. How do you evaluate the currency of the item or the article, for example? Yes, it's just basically it talks about how up to date is it. Dia kemas kini atau tidak. Okay? Okay. Now, can I ask you just throw one poser to you, one question? Does that mean that we cannot accept historical documents? Does that mean that there are times, occasions when you are allowed, it's all right for you to include historical documents in your discussion or in your essay, because you need history. There is a place for history everywhere, anywhere in what you write. As long as it's relevant, then it's salient and relevant, it is. Okay? So you can take something from the 50s, 60s. But in terms of other information, kita minta anda cari yang terkini. Okay? Contohnya, kalau modul ni pun, dia ada banyak edisi kan? Kita ambil edisi yang terkini. Jangan ambil yang lama. Wah, sebab dia edisi. Kalau reprint tak apa. Now we have, saya ada reprint yang lama. Ada menggunakan reprint yang terkini. Tapi tak ada sebarang tindakan pada reprint. Dia cetak semula saja. But kalau edisi, then it is important to make sure you get the correct, the latest edition. That is currency. Apa lagi yang kita nak tengok bila kita nak nilai dari sudut currency? Tarikhnya, publishernya pun, yeah, alright. Lagi, what other info? Year of publishing, yes, tahunnya, edisinya. And copyright, okay. Is, how is that? How is that a link to currency, the currency issue?
I think it's like
that's different. Plagiarism is not copyright. Yeah, it is, but not in terms of currency. Right? But if it's written there, if it's copyright, it's written there, it's copyright, and you cannot be reproduced, it cannot be printed and all that. Can. Right, so,
is
there
anything that you want to give some information which is not correct or something, then you can you take action, right,
with,
let's say, got copyrights.
Yeah,
it's
tapi,
their company.
Betul, tapi kita nak kaitkan dengan isu kemas kini tadi tu. Is that related in the sense of, you know, kita nak tanya, is it, does the copyright punya isu ni, this concern ni, related to the currency? When we evaluating the currency of an article, if we look at copyright, is it going to tell us whether it's going to be current or not current?
You can see the copyright here, right?
Okay. So, you see the year there, will it make a difference? I think the year 2003 or 2005. If unless they say it's one by year addition, you can see on the other front page or the inner page here, okay? Sini. Here, the return year, they have a reprint, they have a new edition. There we can see, but the copyright remains the same. The same one copyright, you see? Cuma dia punya reprint tu mungkin ketiga, keempat, kelima, kan? Okay? This is the eighth printing. Yours is in July. Mine in March, you see? Ini yours is taking it, but it still makes no difference because it's just a reprint. Kalau dia edition, then I've got to go and get a new book. Get the latest. I cannot use that. Alright? So that's one issue, the points we have to take into consideration. Bila kita look at the currency. The last one, scope. Scope. Look at the scope of the topic. Scope tu mengenai apa? Kita kaitkan scope, menilai scope artikel tu, kita kait dari sudut apa? What are we connecting it with? Yeah, definitely. No, topic. Scope of the topic. So, what are we looking at? What are the two things I'm looking at? Kita nilai dari sudut apa? Apa scope? Huh? What is scope? Kemudian dia macam, scope is ruang lingkup kan? How much you are covering. Okay? How much you are covering. The coverage. Yeah? Whether the coverage is comprehensive or not comprehensive. Kita lihat pada target dia. Adakah dia menepati audience, target yang dia kata dia nak siasat, dia nak selidik, dia menepati tak? Dia touch everyone. Sometimes topic is about these people, but dalam dia punya artikel, they just touch only a small group of people. Okay? For example, you have one topic is about, let's say, what? You want to, this is an old issue, but then this is just for, you know, sake of discussion. You want to do a tracer study or analyze the effectiveness of the teaching of maths and science in English. Okay, and your topic scope there will be, you're going to ask the feedback, the views of the teachers, the students, parents, who else? The curriculum developers. All these will be your interested party. But in the discussion, you only touch on only two groups of people, not the entire group of people that you have identified. If that's the case, if your scope adalah terlalu terbatas, dia tak mencakupi semua yang patut dia mencakupi. Okay? Itu scope dia. Example, I give you a report from the JPJ, you know, about the, what they call, motorcycle fatalities for this year. Okay. Now, what is the scope then?